So let us now discuss the another example, right? So yes, we had go through the rule of hybridization, right? What is the rule of hybridization was there? Rule of hybridization, we had checked, it is number of attached atom plus number of lone pairs, right? There is one exception rule, is there? One exception rule. What is one exception rule? Exception rule is that when an atom have one or more lone pair of electrons, and if it attached with sp2 hybridized atom, then lone pair of that atom will consider as sp2, not as sp3. Let's see what this exception rule says. Say for example, if I have this molecule, right? For this nitrogen, if I want to find out the hybridization, so as by the rule, what we will do, we will find out the attached atom. So here carbon is one as a one attached atom and two hydrogen. So total attached atoms are one carbon and two hydrogen, so three plus one lone pair, so total is four, right? So it became sp3 hybridized, but it is not actually sp3 hybridized, because the exception rules are saying yes, when your molecule have one or more lone pair of electrons, right? So here your atom have one lone pair of electrons, and if it is attached with sp2 hybridized carbon. If you will check the hybridization of this carbon, it's a sp2, right? So here it is attached with two atoms, and here with one atom, so it's a sp2. The hybridization of this atom will be considered as sp2. So this will become sp2, right? Not sp3. So this is the exception rule. But if your molecule is like this, right? If it have a directly attached a pi bond, one single pi bond, then you will say it's a sp2. Rule will applicable only to this atom. So now let us understand another example of aromaticity. So for example, we have this atom. Now you understand, each carbon atom have a hydrogen also, and this is a carbon ion, right? Now if you will see the hybridization of this carbon, right? So here one hydrogen, actually this molecule is like this before. To make it easy, I will write it like this way. Hydrogen, it is negatively charged, hydrogen, here is also hydrogen, 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 and it is a negatively charged, and there is a two double bond also there. So if you will count the, if you will consider the hybridization, you will say this is sp2, this is also sp2, this is sp2, this is also sp2. Now by the rule, if you will count the hybridization, right, so it have a 1, 2, 3, right, 3 attached atom and 1 lone pair, so 3 plus 1, that is equal to 4, sp3. But this atom have a 1 lone pair, right? So exception rule is there if there is one or more lone pair, and if this atom is attached to sp2 hybridized atom, then the hybridization of this atom will also considered as the sp2. So actually it is sp2, not as a sp3. So here you can see that every atom is sp2 hybridized. So all the atoms have a p orbitals, and when it have a p orbitals, right here is also p orbitals because sp2 hybridization is there. So the electrons can move into the p orbitals, and then your conjugation will be completed. So whether it is planar or not, yes, your molecule is planar. Whether it is cyclic or not, it is cyclic. It is completely conjugated or not, so every atom in the ring is sp2 hybridized, so it is completely conjugated. How many pi electrons are there? So electrons which are into the p orbitals are considered as the pi electrons. So here you can see there are three hybrid orbitals, right? So there are three hybrid orbitals, sp2, sp2 and sp2. Pi bond can be made by hybridized orbital. So this bond is made by hybridized orbital sp2. This bond is made by hybridized orbital sp2. There are two bond, right? So one bond will be sigma and another will be pi. Sigma bond is made by sp2 hybridization. So now only one orbital is left for this carbon atom, because if I will consider the hybridization of this carbon atom, it is sp2, right? So for the, if it is sp2 hybridized, then there will be three hybrid orbital, sp2, sp2 and sp2, and one p orbital which is not taking part into the hybridization. So as I had told earlier that pi bond will be made by p orbitals. So this is made by p orbitals, right? So this pi bond is made by p orbitals. So electrons in this p orbitals are the pi electrons. Similarly, here it's the same case. So 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 4 pi electrons. Now let us come into this molecule, right? We had considered the hybridization of this molecule is also sp2. So how many orbitals are there? 3 hybrid sp2 orbitals and 1 p orbital. Sigma bond can be made by this hybrid orbital. So this is sigma bond, it's made by sp2. This is also sigma bond, made by sp2. This is also sigma bond, it is also made by sp2. So this all the orbital is utilized to make a sigma bond. So where this lone pair of electrons are? So these lone pair of electrons are the member of p orbital which is left behind. So this is into the p orbital. So electrons which are into the p orbitals will be considered as the pi electrons. So how many pi electrons are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So there are 6 pi electrons, and therefore it is aromatic. Therefore it is aromatic. Let us consider another example, that is pyridine, right? So there is one lone pair of electrons. So now if you will check out the hybridization for every atom, you will find it is sp2 hybridized. Here there will be no exception rule, because I had told earlier that nitrogen is directly attached to this double bond. So it is sp2. So this is sp2 hybridized. This is also sp2 hybridized. This is sp2 hybridized. This is also sp2 hybridized. This is also sp2 hybridized. For nitrogen atom, it is also sp2 hybridized. This nitrogen atom is also sp2 hybridized. So let us start with the nitrogen atom, right? As we know that these are the pi bonds. This is pi bond, pi bond, pi bond. This is sigma bond. This is sigma, sigma, sigma bond. This is sigma and sigma bond. Sigma bond can be made by the sp2 hybrid orbital. So here there are how many? 3 sp2 hybrid orbital is there. Each atom have a 3 hybrid orbital, sp2 hybrid orbital. So 1, 2 and 3rd with the hydrogen. Here also 1, 2 and 3rd with the hydrogen. Bond is made by sp2. So the here p orbital is made the pi bond. So these 6 are the pi electrons. Now what about these 2 lone pair of electrons? So if you will see the hybridization of this nitrogen is what? Sp2, right? So this is sigma bond for this nitrogen. It's made by the sp2, right? This is, I will represent it with the another color so you can easily understand. So this nitrogen have a 3 sp2 hybrid orbital, sp2, sp2, sp2 and 1 p. So this is made by sp2 because of sigma bond. This will also make by sp2 sigma bond. Now we have left one sp2 orbital and one p orbital, and we have what, one pi bond and one lone pair. So as we know that pi bond can be made by p orbital, so p orbital will take part into the making of this pi bond. So p orbital is occupied over here. So this lone pair is part of what? This lone pair is a part of this sp2 hybridized orbital. So this will not consider as the pi electron, because earlier I told you that orbital which is the which is into the p orbital will be considered as the pi electrons, but here these electrons are into the sp2, so it will not consider as the pi electrons. Here in this example it is into the p orbital, that is why we had count, but here we can't count it, right? So how many pi electrons are there? 1 2 3 4 5 6 6 pi electrons, right? Therefore it's a aromatic, right? It's a aromatic compound. Let us have another example. If I have a molecule like this, and I will let us solve it like this to complete its hybridization. So what in this case is aromatic, non-aromatic or anti-aromatic, right? So let us find out the, we will go by the criteria, it is cyclic. Yeah, it's a cyclic compound, it's a planar compound. Now we have to see for the complete conjugation. For the complete conjugation, every atom in the ring should be sp2 hybridized. So as we know, this is sp2, this is sp2.